it's meant to be. I don't know what I'm meant to do. I keep wondering when it'll start. Life. When will life start? And then, there he is at a club in Mitter, dancing with his shirt off, and I think, wow, that guy can really dance. That guy is like fire. And then he looks at me. Me. And I am gone. I pretend not to be. I try to be cool to make it seem like I'm not interested. But I am so interested. And we dance until the sun comes up, and as we step out of the club into the light, I think, this is it. This is life. I am living. And I know he wants to take me home. To his place, or to his friend's place, or to someone's place. I'm not quite sure whose place it is, and I say yes, because at last I'm living and I don't want life to stop. And when he kisses me, I want to cry because I've never been kissed like that before. Not in Halitkov. 3 days we stayed in bed, and after 3 days, I knew some things too. We don't even get up to eat. He disappears and comes back with 2 spoons and a bowl of cereal, and that's all we eat. Cereal from the same bowl for 2 days. On the third day, at night, I watch him sleeping. And I do that thing you shouldn't do. I think about the future. I imagine taking him home to meet mum and dad and my sister and brothers, and how they'll all love him like they love me. And how clever and brave I am to have found such a man, such a beautiful man, different but the same, and brought him all the way back to Halitkov. And then, there I am. I'm so embarrassed, but there I am in the back garden, on Dad's arm, surrounded by his roses. He's got tears in his eyes. And Mum's there in a new dress, which she never lets herself have. And Pip's there with her husband Steve and their 2 girls. They got married in the garden too. And Mark, my oldest brother who I adore, is there with his girlfriend Taylor. And Ben, my other brother, he's there with a girl who's new but won't last because they just don't with Ben. And I love them all so much. Sometimes I think too much if you can love too much. But now, I need to make room for Emmanuel, who's standing there in a suit, and he is just so, so handsome. And I'm in a white dress. And I'm kind of shocked, kind of surprised, because I didn't even know that that's what I wanted. Maybe it's what I think Mum and Dad will want for me, but anyway, there I am in the backyard on Dad's arm, walking across the lawn in a white dress, and then he wakes up. And he looks at me as if he knows what I'm thinking about, and as if he wants to run, so I kiss him before he can. And he smiles. And I am gone all over again. And as I fall asleep on his chest, I listen to the beat of his heart, and I could listen to that for the rest of my life. I think, is this it? Is this what falling in love is? And then, when I wake up, he's gone. With 400 euros from my wallet, my iPad, a camera, my favorite scarf, and a large piece of my heart.
Garden where I grew up.
Is that what you call it now when you come? A visit. A visit is something a relative you don't know very well does once a year. Something they've just got to get through. This is different. This is you coming home, which you do 3 or 4 times a week. The thing is, when you come, you don't sit. You come. You do what needs to be done, and then you go. And that's just the way it is. So now, I find you sitting. And I'm pretty sure something's wrong. Is this about Steve?
I'm leaving him.
Does he know yet?
He will soon.
You might want to drop the kids over. Give yourself some room to talk.
You're not surprised?
No. I've seen this coming. The writing's been on the wall for some time.
And what did it say, Mum? This writing.
It said, I'm not happy, in big black letters.
Don't.
What?
Pretend that you know more about my life than I do.
I'm just saying.
Let me be the expert on that at least.
Somebody got up on the wrong side of bed this morning.
This was a bad idea.
Don't you walk away from this. You're not 12 years old anymore.
What will you do, Mum? Pull my hair? Slap my face?
Do you remember when Rosie fell off the ladder?
She was 2.
18 months, if that.
You'd asked me to watch her. You were busy inside.
I was doing the house.
But I didn't really want to. I was trying to get a tan. I was lying in the sun in my bikini and you kept saying that I'd burn.
You didn't have the skin for it. You still don't.
But I was determined that that summer I'd get a tan.
You've got your father's skin.
I only closed my eyes for a moment. Dad had left the ladder up against the shed.
He never did that again.
And I didn't know that she could climb. Babies can't climb ladders.
She could.
I can still hear the crack of her skull hitting the path.
I heard it from the kitchen.
I screamed. You ran outside to see what had happened. You just looked at me. And I swear, I went cold. You could do that with just a look.
I still can.
But particularly to me, Mum. You do that to me. I ran inside. I hid under the bed and you came after me.
Here we go.
You came after me and you pulled me out from under the bed by my hair.
Hell, you wouldn't come out.
By my hair.
I couldn't reach anything else.
You tore the hair from my head.
It was just a few strands.
It was a clump with skin.
I was in shock. I was angry. I was tired. 4 kids I had and 1 day a week to clean the house. I asked you to do 1 thing, to watch over your sister. But you were too selfish, too vain to do it.
Vain?
Lying in the sun like your princess bloody muck instead of watching your sister.
I wasn't vain, I was trying to fit in. To be like all the other girls. I was a mouse, Mum. A mouse. The only thing that I thought was pretty about myself was my hair. Which is what you tore from my head. Funny that.
It was a moment. A moment of anger.
I had a bald patch for a whole term and it still doesn't grow properly there.
It was one time. And now what? You're unhappy because I pulled your hair when you were 12 years old.
I was 14.
Are you going to tell Dad? Or will I?
Go right ahead.
Oh, Bob, she's leaving Steve because I pulled her hair when she was 14 years old. She's been unhappy ever since.
Things haven't been good for a while, Mum.
Well, I know there's been a rough patch, but that's true for most marriages.
I've tried.
Have you thought about trying some more?
I'm not happy, Mum.
There's that word again. Happy. As if that's the point of living. And what about Steve? How does he feel about all this?
Well, I think he'd like things to stay the same.
You have a husband who loves you, who treats you well, and who's been a wonderful father, and you're walking away from that.
Not easily.
It just doesn't make sense.
I know. He's a good man.
Oh. I get it.
What?
There's someone else.
No.
Look at me.
I'm doing this for myself.
Yeah. That much is clear.
Can't you just take my side, Mum?
The man's done nothing wrong. He's loved you and been a wonderful father. Why would I make an enemy of him?
I don't love him.
Too bad. You've got kids. You make it work. Now look at me and tell me there's no other man. Oh, you stupid girl.
Don't.
Why would you do this to yourself?
Mum, please don't.
Just please. God,
tell me he's not married.
And what about the girls?
Where are they in all this?
I've been offered a position in Vancouver, and I'm going to take it.
You're taking the girls from him now too?
They're staying here.
Now hold on. I don't think that's right, Pip.
The position is for 12 months. I'm going to see how it goes, and at the end we'll decide what's best.
Do you hear what you're saying?
If it was a man making this decision, if it was Mark or Ben, you would support it.
Not if they're walking out on their kids.
This is a professional opportunity, Mum. My work is important to me.
And who's going to pick up the slack with the kids? I've been a mother for 34 years. I'm over it.
I'm not asking you to do any more than you're already doing.
But how's he going to cope for 12 months? On his own?
Same as I would if it was him going.
But you'd have me. And Dad. You know you would. Day and night. And you've got ahead in this knowing that we will be there. You made a decision 9 years ago to have children. You don't just walk away from that.
Things don't have to stay the same. People work things out differently now. Steve is as good as a parent as I am.
Those girls need their mother.
Not if she's unhappy.
You selfish bitch. Your happiness is not what matters here.
Because you know what happens then, Mum. She will make sure that her children are unhappy too. She will choose one of them and make sure that she feels like shit about herself.
What happened, Pip? Did some guy bored with his life look twice at you and make you feel like you were more than a mouse? You are walking out on your kids. Christ, Pip. You know what you get when you treat a girl like a princess? You get a fucking princess!
You are going to annihilate me.
Toughen up! You'll need to if you're planning to shack it with some Canadian for the winter. What's the most important thing in a woman's life? And don't make the mistake of thinking it's love.
I wasn't.
Or children. Those things are fine, but they are not what matter. It's independence. Without that, the others are just a trap. A woman needs to stand on her own 2 feet and earn her own money. That's the best advice you'll ever get from me. So get a job.
I have a job.
One that you'll still want to be doing when you're 40 years old and not so pretty.
Why do you always make me cut the onions? You say, come, I'll teach you how to cook. And I only end up cutting onions.
And look how well you cut them.
It's not fair.
It's a mother's job to make her children cry. One way or another.
Why?
So they understand pain.
That is so wrong.
What's he doing?
I don't know.
Bob! Bob! What are you doing? The manure, you're doing the garden. I'm not looking after him if he gets dementia. I've looked after people all my life.
Then I will.
That's enough onion. Do me some carrots as well. A fine dice, cubes and not rectangles. I worry about him, Rosie.
He's all right, isn't he?
I want to take him away.
Where to?
To Europe. To America. To all those places you're meant to go. I want to leave you lot and all your troubles behind. I want it to be just him and me again. Before.
Before what?
Before I forget what that's like.
Can you afford it?
You're not to tell your dad. But I've got a stash.
Of what?
Of money, what do you think? Ever since my very first job, I've always put a little bit away. Even if it was just £5. It all adds up, Rosie. Compound interest.
What, Bob? No, I haven't used your secateurs!
He's older than he needs to be. And he knows much less of the world than he should.
Yeah, but he's happy with what he has, Mum.
That's because he thinks he doesn't deserve more. You work for a car maker's for 30 years. You know nothing else, and then one day they close the door and tell you you're not needed anymore. They give you a package and tell you that's all you're worth. And it seems like a hell of a lot of the time, when all you're used to is a fortnightly pay packet, and so you believe them. A few years later, that money's nearly all gone. And so you satisfy yourself with a bed of roses. I hate those roses.
Mum, they're just an excuse for not living.
Why don't you stop work, so you have more time together?
Because I'd bash him to death with a shovel if I had to spend every day with him. And then I'd kill myself from boredom. No. I like work. I like who it lets me be.
Wishing that her face was not quite so round and that her hair didn't fall quite so straight from her head. Is that what we do to our daughters? Praise them, while secretly we think they're not good enough. The moment they start to become women, the first shedding of blood, do you remember how early I was? The first sign of a developing breast, is that when we start to think that they're not pretty enough? Or smart enough? Is that when we start thinking that they're never gonna find someone? Or be someone? Is that what we do? Maybe it is better that girls are brought up by their dads, who look at them and only see the best. Like Dad. That's what he sees when he looks at me. And I wish you could too. I never really understood the song when I was younger. I still don't. But I didn't know enough to know that it was about love. And that every time you played it, you wanted to cry. You never did, of course. Not with us around. Only once did I see you let yourself go. You thought you were alone. In the backyard. Leaning up against the old gum tree, bashing your head against the trunk, howling and howling. Why were you crying that day, Mum? I'm sorry that I never asked you. Why didn't we have those conversations? I think that perhaps we were too busy hiding from each other what really mattered. And so, I'm sitting here in my apartment in Vancouver, and it's threatening to snow. And I hope it does, because that's a good enough reason not to go out.
I'm playing this song, and I'm wondering why it meant so much to you. And I can only ask that from a distance, because I'm scared of seeing the truth in your face like you saw it in mine. I met him at an education conference here in Vancouver on that first trip. I didn't see it coming. Do you ever see it coming? So yes, your accusation of there being another man was right. Are you ever wrong, Mum? I was ready. For him. For love. A Canadian. A public education specialist. A man who spoke with passion about something that I stopped caring about years ago. It wasn't hard. I was ready to fall for someone. Someone who cared about what mattered. And so I fell, Mum, in love. 3 days at a conference, 6 months of thrilling emails, text messages, clandestine phone calls, and I knew that I had to come. He's married, of course, but you knew that too. 3 children, a son and 2 daughters, to a woman who is good and fine and bright and beautiful. I don't care, because I feel loved by him like I never felt loved by Steve. My good, sweet husband, who has never done anything but care for me and the children, but who does not look further in life than the end of his own driveway. And so I'm waiting for his call, my lover, and I'm wondering if he will find a way to leave his good wife, sweet children, and safe home to come to me. I didn't want to be this woman, Mum. But I can't leave. I won't. Eventually he'll have to make a decision, and it probably won't be me. But for now, well, for now I am this woman. Thanks for taking the trouble from her eyes. Do you remember that line of the song? Well, that is what this man has done for me. And I'm wondering if there'd be someone who could have done it for you. If you'd let them. My love.